Good afternoon and welcome to Spielberg, and to a circuit that in one form or another has held every Austrian Grand Prix in the championship, except the very first back in 1964. It was at this race that John Watson lost a bet and his beard when he took Team Penske's only F1 victory in 1976. If anything, the stakes are even higher today, with 25 points available for victory and a crucial advantage in the championship fight. It's one of the shortest laps on the calendar today then, with 7 rights and just 3 lefts, making up the 10 corners of this high-speed circuit. Turn 2 is barely a corner at all. They'll be flat out through there, a left-hand kink into the uphill braking zone of Turn 3. Turns 1, 3 and 4 are all potential opportunities to overtake. Anthony Davidson joins me to talk you through the action here today. What is quite an unusual racetrack, wouldn't you say, Ant?
Yeah, it's quite an odd layout around here. The thing about Austria is that it's a harder circuit to master than what really meets the eye. On top of that, it's a low grip surface, and that means that your small mistakes end up being punished, and it's very easy to slide wide into the runoff area and lose a huge chunk of time. Luckily, because it's such a short circuit though, you have plenty of opportunities to perfect the lap.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Davidson lines up on pole position, edging out Max Verstappen, who'll start from P2. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Bottas, Leclerc, Sebastian Vettel, and Magnussen. Norris, Perez, Grosjean, and George Russell. Stroll, Hamilton, Robert Kubica, and Kvyat. Gasly, Ricciardo, Nico Hülkenberg, and Kimi Räikkönen. Albon and Antonio Giovinazzi starts from the back of the grid. And now it's time to head down to the track.
Okay, the run into turn one isn't too long, so the pack will be bunched up. Take care. System checks are good. We need to stay in formation and start bringing the car up to temperature, please. Get some load into the tyres and work the brakes. We want them nice and warm by the end of the lap. Radar is clear. Weather is looking good for now. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid has formed. Be ready with the clutch. We're looking good from the start. Great work. That's a new fastest lap for the race. Hitting the rated limits on the MGU-H, the power unit is going to be more prone to overheating. There's 15 laps of fuel remaining. We pretty much burned off our excess fuel. We'll be back on target soon. Don't wait too long to turn the engine down. One more stop today, one stop left in our strategy. You have four laps till your pit window opens. pitting this lap then. Come into the pits at the end of this lap. Seeing some signs of abrasion on your tyres now. They should still be good to run on, but they won't be at their best. Is 30.2 seconds.
Thank you.
pit stop. Five laps of fuel remaining. So far. Some information on Leclerc, they're slowing down. It seems like there's some kind of problem with their car. Of fuel remaining. We'll be right back. This is your final lap of the race. Absolutely awesome. Just amazing. Well done.
What a fantastic Grand Prix that was, and an excellent win for McLaren. What do you think it was, Ant, that gave them the edge over the competition today?
Well, I know it's a bit of a boring answer, but the truth is they simply had the best speed package on the day, and a driver who knows how to take advantage of that. It doesn't matter how much time you spend poring over the stats and planning strategies if you can't keep the pace, and our winner today showed they could do both.
And look at that, they're making their way out onto the podium now. Great race from the McLaren team, and I'm really happy to see them there on the top step of the podium.